Hey guys, and welcome back to a brand new Devlog, episode number 6. As promised, in this episode, we're gonna be working on a wave system. Right now, there are a lot of enemies spawning, without stop and without logic. A really strong enemy can randomly spawn, and they can just spawn endlessly, and it creates a lot of enemies, and a lot of enemies also creates a lot of lag. And that's where the wave system comes in. We're gonna make the wave system just like any other tower defense game, where you can skip waves and waves will come out, and with higher difficulties the waves will be bigger, etc, etc. You guys have been telling me that a lot of you guys have been having problems with making your own wave system. So I'm gonna show you guys how I am going to make it, and hopefully it will help some of you guys out. Let's get to the coding. So the first thing that I wanna do inside of data is make a new module script, and we're gonna call this module script wave data. So inside of this module, I want to be a bit more optimized than I normally. So I'm going to make two tables. I'm going to make general data, and I'm going to make module.wavedata. So inside of wave data, we're going to do all the island creatures and all the waves. And inside general data, we're going to put general data. For example, like time, tail, spawn. And let's make that point 2 for now. So unless other specified, the time tail spawn is point 2, which just helps us keep everything cleaner. Inside of the wave data, we're gonna make it for the island map, and inside here we're gonna make all the waves. So like this is one wave, this is two waves, and this means 3 waves. So this map has 3 waves. You need to tell them, yo, these are the enemies that go into the wave. And all the data for that is in our other data script, data entity. So for example, we want to place snails in the first wave. So what are we gonna do? We're gonna do brackets snail, brackets snail, brackets snail, brackets snail. So this means in the first wave, 4 snails are going to spawn. And we can also do that for the future waves. So for example, in the second wave, I want 3 crabs to spawn. Okay, so I want to mention this real quick. I just realized how much HP snails have, so I changed the waves up. In wave 1, 3 crabs are gonna spawn. In wave 2, 3 crabs and 1 snail are gonna spawn. And in wave 3, 4 snails are gonna spawn. I'm gonna be honest, this is not balanced at all. Like, totally not balanced. But at least it helps us, you know, show the idea of how a wave system works. Now, obviously, just adding data isn't going to spawn it correctly, and it's still going to spawn randomly. And that is because we need to change the way how spawning works. Right now, it just picks a random enemy, but we actually need to be able to tell it, yo, listen to me, you need to spawn from the waves. And to make this really simple, we're first going to be able to spawn it for one wave only. Only the first wave, to give you guys an idea how it's going to work. So inside of our main script, we're gonna remove options, bam. And instead of only sending in path, we're also gonna be sending in entity name. And then here with entity name, we're gonna replace that with entity name. Boom boom. So this one is done. Now of course, for the spawning enemy, this needs to be completely rewritten. So first we need to get the wave data. So local wave data equals require game replicated storage data, wave data. So now we required the script. We're also gonna say which map it is. So local map equals island. Okay, that's all really, really cool. So now we're gonna make, you can comment this all out for now. So let's just toggle comments and we're gonna do spawn enemies according to wave. So we're gonna do 4i equals 1, comma, then hashtag wave data dot wave data, then brackets like these, map, and then 1 do. So this is gonna loop through the entirety of the enemies. What we can do then is we can, you know, find the enemy that we're gonna find. So local.entity name equals, and what we can do right then and there is do wave data, map, 1, and then I. So this will get the name of the enemy, book it an enemy name. Then we obviously want to copy this because we have to find a path again. And then we can do spawn enemy, path, and then entity name. So I'm gonna put a wait 3 here, so it waits for us to load in. You wanna replace this wait with like wait till all players have spawned. So wait till all players spawn. Then we're gonna print start. So you wanna replace this with like, oh, we need 4 players for this map, so keep waiting till 4 players arrive. And in here, we're gonna do local.defaultWaitTime equals wave data, general data, time till spawn. And what you can do then at the end here is wait default wait time. And this should spawn exactly 3 crabs on the map. Not more, not less. Let's see if that works. Okay, so we are in the map. We see the word start. Let's see if we can find a crab. So that's 1 crab, 2 crab, 3 crab. So 0.2 might be a little bit too quick. Like they're literally stuck in each other and we don't want that. So 0.2 is way too quick. Way too quick. Luckily, we can just change that to 0.5. And then let's actually put in a little bit more crabs, like 6, just for a test right now. And if we play it again, we're gonna see and wait for the crabs to spawn. So we got 1 crab, 2 crab, then 1 crab over there, and then 3 crab, 4 crab, 5 crab. So really nice, really cool. We got the actual crabs spawning. I am super, super happy about that. But unfortunately, this is only 1 wave. And we want to be able to progress to the next waves, aren't we? Okay, so I made a very basic wave display. So it will display, huh, you are at wave 0. And then we're gonna use that to upgrade through each wave and basically display to us like what wave we are on. So let's actually code it so we can go to the next wave. So in our code, we can do local.waves equals, and then we're gonna do wave data, map, and then we do a hashtag before. So this is the number of waves that we have in our map. So then we can do 4 wave equals 1 hashtag waves do, and then we're gonna put this inside of here. And now, instead of saying 1 here, we're gonna do wave. And now it's gonna loop through every single wave. Of course, you want to have like a little cooldown here, like 2 seconds. So after everything has spawned, it takes 2 seconds before the next wave begins, because we don't want the waves to go like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's way too fast. So this will go through all the waves and all the enemies. It's very, very simple, actually. And if we test it out, we get an error. Wait. And if we test it out, we are on wave 1, which means we get 3 little crabs. Then we are on wave 2. I mean, the enemies take a while to get out of the water. So wave 2, and it's more crabs. And we get an error. Huh? Wait, why did we get an error? Entity name is Nail. Why? Huh? Wait a minute. Okay, I made a mistake. This 1 over here should also be wave. Haha, haha. So now if we test it out, we are on wave 1, which means 3 crabs will come up. So 1, 2, 3. Now we are on wave number 2, which means 3 crabs and 1 snail will come out. So 1, 2, 3 crabs. Let's wait for the snail. The snail is a bit slower, but we are also on wave 3, which means 4 snails will come out. So let's actually wait for the snails to come out of the water. So there is the 1, still from wave number 2. And in a couple of seconds, these are the snails from wave number 3. So yeah, the wave system totally, totally works. It still needs a bit of work, like we don't want snails to be this close on each other, etc, etc. But for now, it actually works pretty, pretty perfectly. But in the tower defense, normally the next wave only spawns when you kill all the enemies from the wave. And that is not the case in our system. So let's fix that real, real quick. Making the tower damage a bit higher, so we can easily test. Okay, so I think I okay, it loads a bit slow. I think I completely fixed it. So it is wave 1 right now, and only wave 1. So let's wait for the crabs to come out. So there are the crabs, and let's wait. Will the number change on its own? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, it doesn't change to wave 2. But what if we place one of our towers over here, and over here? And we kill the crabs. Will it go to wave 2? So crab is down, and crab is down, and crab is down. And let's see if it changed to wave 2. It changed to wave number 2. So that completely works. And there are the new crabs, and of course the snail is all the way under the water, which if we go under the water, we can see there is the snail. He goes all the way up, and because we didn't kill them of course yet, it doesn't go to wave number 3. So they're all going up, la la la, and then and boom and boom and boom. Okay, so now we obviously need to kill the snail, so let's actually place one over here. And boom and boom and boom, and that killed the snail, which means boom, now we are at wave 3, the final wave. And that obviously means that the snails are actually spawning. Hello, little snails. There you go. Yeah, you can do it. Nice, nice, nice. So of course, there is so much more that you can do with this script. Like you can actually do like in general data, like wave cooldown time. Like every wave, it takes 3 seconds until the next wave starts. We can also use this to give money. So wave money would be 200. So every new wave you get 200 money. Just like that. But we want to be a bit more specific with the enemies. So I really want to be able to specify certain things for certain enemies and certain waves. For example, I actually want in wave 2, I want them to come out of the other side of the map. Or I want this specific crab to spawn 5 seconds later than the rest. So how we're gonna do that is, for example, I want this crab on wave 2 to spawn on the other island. Only this crab. So I can do brackets. And then the first value will just be the entity. And then we can do a comma. And we can do the node name. So in our case, the second node is node B. And now this crab will spawn in node B. Well, it wouldn't really spawn there. It would, you know, try to spawn there. And we're gonna do nil. And you might wonder what a nil is for. So we're gonna make a comment over here. So if we do a table, it's entity, node, and time. Okay? So for example, I want this snail in the third wave to be, it can spawn at the default node. But I wanted to spawn after 8 seconds, so very late. So entity is snail, the node is nil, so it doesn't matter, and he spawns after 8 seconds. So how are we gonna do that inside of the script? It's pretty simple. So first we're gonna check if type, and then we're gonna do this value. Okay, like that. Equals equals table. Then. And then we're also gonna do an else statement. So this, what we just typed, can go into the else statement. So this means the entity is default. If it is in a table, it means that the entity has specific. So the entity has specific orders. Okay, so first of all, we want to get the entity name. So local entity name equals wave data dot wave data map. Then we're gonna do wave I, not one, I, and then one, because the first value is always the name. Okay, so then what we're gonna do is we're gonna do local path equals wave data dot wave data map wave I and 2, because 2 is our node. And of course we're gonna do local wait time equals wave data dot wave data map wave I 3. And now that we got all this, we can literally copy this under here. And we're gonna do path entity name, and this is gonna be wait time. Here is the issue. Because some variables are set to nil, this would error. So we're gonna do a failsafe. So if path equals equals nil, then path equals paths 1, and if wait time equals equals nil, then wait time equals default wait time, and now this should totally work. But let's test that out, shall we? Okay, so nothing should have changed on wave number 1. So all the 3 crabs should come out of the water on this side. That totally works. So let's place down 2 of our towers over here. And let's see. So in the second wave, 1 crab would have spawned over here if everything goes alright. So boom, boom, and boom. So he died. So now we're gonna go to wave number 2 and we get an error. Damn it! Okay, ha 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 ha. That should work. So we're gonna get wave 1. So let's place down our towers. Indeed, it's tree crap. So let's just get to wave 2 as fast as possible to see if it actually works. So it's gonna attack and boom and boom and boom. Okay, cool. So now we're gonna head on to wave number 2 and 2 crabs should spawn over here and 1 crab should spawn over there. So indeed, 1, 2 crabs, and over here, all the way over here, is 1 crab. So that worked. So let's actually kill this 1 crab. Boom. So now in wave number 3, we should get a snail after 8 seconds. First we have to kill this snail, obviously. So let's kill this snail to move on to wave number 3. Let's go, you can do it! Go! Almost! And boom! Okay, so now the snails should spawn. Let's move our camera underwater. So it's indeed a 1, 2, and 3 snails. And after a couple of seconds, the last snail should spawn. And there he is! So all these special instructions totally worked. And you can go a lot more wild with this. But this gives you the basic ID. And now let's kill all these snails. Bye bye. Boom, boom. Boom. Bam. Boom. Bam. Boom. Boom. Bam. Bam. And boom. Bam. Yay, we completed the game. Honestly, a wave system is what makes a tower defense game a tower defense game. In the next episode, I really wanna go on upgrading towers. Probably without money yet, but we might also add money. Who knows? Could be a good challenge. The game is really coming along and I love it. It's almost fully playable. And I am actually already working on a second map for the game and more starter towers. So stay tuned for that. But anyway guys, thank you all so much for watching this devlog. If you wanna see more progress on this game, please leave a like and maybe consider subscribing. Anyway, I'm gonna head out. Thank you guys all so much for watching. Bye bye.